There have been several people who have been tested. Of the blood work that came back positive recently that we saw, those individuals were actually not even workers. They were just residents who had been living in the area. Most of them lived, you know, near the shoreline, but in like the Orange Beach, like more like the Alabama and Florida area, not even down in Louisiana. And these people were tested using the volatile solvents profile, which is a blood test for hydrocarbons. And they came back positive for a lot of, for various different hydrocarbons, ethylbenzene, and a lot, I mean, just ran a lot of random, all of the molecules were actually hydrocarbons, weren't tested for the compounds or for the markers and correct it at all. We're not 100% sure on that, but they did turn out positive for sure for exposure to oil.
And it's deadly because it's cumulative, and the problem is, you can only imagine what, because we can only test for one at a time, and, you know, we tested, like Heather said, for the oil, and next is going to be the Corexit, and, you know, it's just so difficult to test for Corexit because you don't even know everything that's in it. But the issue here is that these are the residents. These aren't even the workers. Everyone is getting sick, and this is just, the people are going to keep getting sick from how the oil is basically, it's becoming like an aerosol in the air, and that's what's happening, especially with storms and rain and everything else, and no one is talking about this. No one. We're releasing this ourselves, like you said, because, you know, just no one wants to hear it, but we have the paperwork, the tests, and everything is coming back positive, and it's coming back at an extremely alarming amounts, and it's just scary to see that. I mean, our hearts sank, and you know, we worked with Michelle Nix and Gulf Coast Volunteers and Sassafras and Joe Billups to get this testing done, because it took that much of a combined effort to actually get it together and get the doctors and the chemists. But we've had it analyzed, and it's from three different sources, the same crap that's in the water and in the air and in the ocean and in sand is now in our blood. It's bad.
The studies haven't been done because this exposure is just, the studies, there's no funding for these studies or whatever. Even animal studies, a lot of them haven't been done. But those that have, a lot of these compounds, they're known carcinogens. This may be something that doesn't show up for, you know, 20 years, and then suddenly a bunch of people. And that's a really scary thing, too, because it's really, right now, these people, if they become sick, terminally ill, say, they might be able to get, you know, out of a lawsuit something very concrete. But without the evidence 20 years down the line, you know, what kind of settlement are these people going to get when they can't even prove the testing is not being done? And that's our biggest goal right now, is to keep getting people tested, because that's the only thing that will prove. And unfortunately, it's a really expensive process, but that's the only thing that will prove concretely that these people are being exposed, and that hopefully down the line, if problems do occur, and you know, they may occur now, they may occur in 20 years, it depends on the person. Obviously, a lot of people are more chemically sensitive than others, and you know, cancer does take time to develop.
Right.
So, I mean, it's a huge priority for us, because, you know, these people need proof.